Sri Lanka is considered to be an ideal destination for Indian travelers, as both the countries share some interesting mythological history. Besides its exotic culture, this island nation is home to astonishing landscapes and amazing wildlife. With India being the number one country in terms of the tourist arrivals to Sri Lanka in 2017, it seems that Indians have really recognized the potential their neighbor nation possesses so far for their travel goals. In an exclusive interview with MIG TV, the Tourism Minister of Sri Lanka expresses his vision towards what else the ancient country plans for its impending Indian travelers.
I would like to request them to celebrate their marriage also in Sri Lanka and then have the honeymoon. That would be the best that we could offer, where they'll be very comfortable. And Sri Lanka is having all hotels, 5-star, 4-star, 3-star, 2-star, formal, informal, homestays, spread throughout the country. So accommodation is so freely available. We have first of all identified all the sites which are connected with the Ramayana. We have all put them together. In fact, we launched a website some time ago, I think in one of the Indian states. All tourists who come, they first go in search of these spots. So we have a proper documentary. We have come up with some program during our lean period. That is June, July, August, September, October. We have told our airlines to come down in their rates and told the hoteliers also to come down in their rates, which will give an encouragement. Today people look at cost, very important. Even Indians, they also see how much they have to spend and how much they save. The end of it must have return on your investment. That's what you need. Tourism Minister is now very keen on doing it. And India, Sri Lanka have been world-renowned cricket champions from time to time. Now the IPL is coming up. All that are very important. But more than that, the latest that we are trying to do is to develop adventure tourism. Adventure tourism meaning kite surfing, ballooning, whale watching, dolphin watching, golfing. All those are new areas that have been opened up, and a lot of tourists don't remain in Colombo. They go for this outstation, ecotourism, hitchhiking. One reason is connectivity. Second reason is food. Third reason is free of pollution. Fourth reason is we have the best of hotels, ranging from top to bottom. And we have the Ramayana trail. And the cultural side. Lord Buddha has visited Sri Lanka on 3 occasions. There are 6 UNESCO sites which have been highly respected by world over. So these are all opportunities they have, the wildlife we have, as I mentioned, the cultural side. Everything is there in a couple of hours. That's the most important thing. You go from the hill country, the world's famous tea manufacturing units, downwards,